there. I'm Kate.
And I'm Eleanor.
And we're with the Aquatic Invasive Strike Force. Today, we're removing the invasive water chestnut. This is the invasive water chestnut. It forms dense mats on the water surface and prevents sunlight from penetrating through the water column, which stops native plant growth.
Other impacts of water chestnut include blocking pathways for boaters and fisherfolk, as well as depleting the dissolved oxygen within the water. This is because when the plant dies off, the bacteria that decompose it consume most of the oxygen in the water. This can also lead to harmful algal blooms.
Timing is critical for water chestnut removal. The ideal removal period is from mid-June to late July, and if needed, early August. The reason for this timing is because around August, the seed pods begin to drop, and each seed pod can produce up to 20 plants, and each plant can produce up to 20 seeds.
In order to effectively remove water chestnut, we have to remove the whole plant, including the roots. And so we start with the rosette and making sure not to break off the roots. Carefully pull up the entire plant. As Kate mentioned, each seed can turn into multiple plants. So we want to make sure to get the roots so we can get the residual seeds on the bottom as well.
When disposing of the water chestnut, it's very important to do it properly, whether it's throwing them in trash bags or placing them 100 feet away from the water to decompose naturally.
Thanks for tuning in, and we hope to see you protecting New York's waters one water chestnut removal at a time.